God.
Hallelujah.
My name is Ogujo Jackson. Many people know me for this community. I spent 10 years for this community, the Fire Park Art. They know me. You are the drink and womanizer. I just to show the testimony. Since when I joined this ministry, I don't do many deliverance. The hush of the alcohol is dead. From that 2017 till now, no alcohol, no woman. So I'm here to return the glory to many people know me for this community. The kind life when I need for this community, before I come up for this community. For this ministry, change my life, change many things, transform me. Every vision I go fit talk out for this public. But God Almighty know what he do for me for this ministry. I'm here to return the glory to God, to the God of God of Pastor John Mike. He goes so too.
Clap your hands for Jesus. Clap for Jesus. You said you were here in this community?
10 years.
You spent 10 years here.
Yes.
And you said for that 10 years you were womanizing?
Womanizing alcohol. No bar for this community when they don't know me. No bar. They know. The people went there, they know me.
Can we wave our hands if anybody can attest to that? You know him.
Drink. When you go talk about one of our drink, no kind of drink. No kind of drink.
But after you encounter grace.
Yes.
Drinking.
Drinking and womanizer excess.
What kind of alcohol were you taking?
I can't count them. Beer. Any kind of hot. If there are big Capari. Before I stop, there are big Capari. I feel the buyer from my room at the finisher. Even a red wine. Even a six. They know me. They know me for this community.
Can you make a joyful noise to God? Hallelujah.
I know my face is very familiar to persons here. You have already seen me, and so many persons I invited you here to come and listen to this testimony, particularly on what God has done in my life. Because I encountered grace mightily, not be small play matter. I encountered grace. So it happened, I was not seeing things in a different way. These people were not doing things that to my spirit, and I was feeling this is not supposed to be done this way. This is not supposed to be done this way. But because I've encountered grace and people happen to encounter grace. The thing was not like this boy don't decrease. That was the news all around that, like, say people don't special because we don't decrease. But due to my understanding with the Holy Ghost Spirit, I told my family it's not time for me to leave Alaja first. Make I come out Alaja for like 2, 3 days, 5, 6 days. I come out Alaja. But while I was out of Alaja, I was indicated with my elder sister. While I was there, I was privileged to attend while I was indicated in a house, I was praying severely that God, this was something I was admiring about people that were carrying Bible about, like, I like people like this person. No, now this is not my portion. Why must my own be? People not going to say I don't do it. I was praying. My sister was even confused. I beg, you know, before let me go cry, say, if like saying a pastor, you mark the church, and so that they pray, wah, now there you go. I laugh, I say, yes, so now then me, I go, I must go there. She gave me ticket. On Sunday, I think that was on the 27th or 28th, on Sunday, November, I was there mightifully. The first thing I met in the show was testimony. I rushed to the testimony, and I was like, I want to give testimony. They encountered me, they ministered to me, and that's what my testimony. I said, I want to cut it short. Like, I was in the act of smoking. I've left smoking, but that was all. But on Sunday, I was there in that service. When I was there, I encountered grace. It was the man of God, the whole preaching, the whole sermon, the man of God was giving was directed to me mightily. People, not be joke, Alaja. This is why they talk, not be joke. I don't come out to, I don't remove, I don't know that spiritual realm now, and I'm not going to know. But I've not said the grace will come up, so will come up people for here. In the name of Jesus. I was into the art, Yahweh, Yahweh.
Yes. Number one.
I was into the art, Yahweh, Yahweh. And I was also into the art, drinking. You know, get what I know if you drink. I don't go Chris. I go drinker. The big gun, I wine, no hot to any other taker. No. The highest, not sleep, it go make me sleep.
Number three.
And the thing is that I'm a very playful person. I take everything very similar. If you ask me, the thing that my brother will give you, if you like, make a check, go ask. I know the man.
Number three.
The third is that I humanize, not be joke. If I see girl. Four. Now that grace, my order give me. That grace. If they raise any out before, but now, if I will see girl, they hate her.
Third, fourth one.
Now, since boy, doctor there, yeah. Is there a doctor here?
Yes.
Can doctor attest to this? I owe boy go do before go start to the sperm, go start to the produce from me, but how old?
Now, how old were you when you started masturbation?
Then I started masturbating.
For like, how old were you? Like 10 years old?
I don't think that. Maybe 14, 15. That was when I started masturbating.
So you did it for like
so
how many
P,
years?
So P, no, no, no. So P, I don't do as so P. I don't do as this boy. As a boy, start to come sperm.
But after you encounter grace,
it don't come out.
The spirit of masturbation.
Out.
The spirit of womanizing.
Out.
The spirit of acquiring.
Out.
The spirit of Yahoo.
Genesis chapter 1, verse 2, and verse 3, and verse 4.
Make a joyful noise to God. Make a joyful noise to God.
In worship,
come on,
Yahweh.
Somebody lift your hand and sing with Bada. Come on, let's go.
We Yahweh. Lift your hand, sing Yahweh.
Was without what? Form, void, and darkness was upon the face of the deep. Verse 3, he said, and God said, let there be what? Light. And there was light. Verse 4, after verse 3, he said, and God saw the light that he pronounced about. God did not just say, let there be light. He saw it. Now, from the creation of God that he has created Elijah, created you and I, he has given the authority for you and I to pronounce the same light. But come here, sir, that the light that God has given Elijah, everybody know at the time in Elijah, this was where we talk about even the oil company. Everybody running here, busy company. Look at, what did they call this company here? DSC? Is that correct? Other company, B plus B, everywhere was jammed with Elijah. God said, let there be light. The first thing we are here to handle tonight is subduing darkness. Subduing darkness that prevents your settlement. Subduing darkness that prevents your what? I hear the shout of God. Darkness represents unsettlement. Darkness represents unsettlement. He said, and the earth was without form and void. That is not the problem. And he said, darkness was upon the face. That was a problem. Because after God have discovered the first problem, and knowing what to do to bring to pass, the first thing he saw was a darkness that incapacitated the people. If you go to Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 12, the Bible says, for we wrestle not against flesh, neither against blood, not against ordinarily, but against principalities, against powers. And the next one he said, against rulers of what? Darkness. So the battle of Elijah is a battle of darkness. The battle that does not want Elijah experience peace, experience settlement. I was surprised when I came the other time, they said Elijah still don't have light. And from the foundation of Elijah, one of the problem is light. Light that God has pronounced. But the problem is beyond the physical appearance. I told you how the forces came to me. That was quite 4 months or 5 months ago. So they have seen the light that was coming. And they decided to come and say, don't step here to do anything. That is to say, they have kept the people under captivity. They've kept them under bondage. And unfortunately, the people also enjoyed the bondage. The people also enjoyed the battle of the captivity. Look at the first two testimonies of these young men. How their life was. And they said they have to relocate. Now, if everybody relocates from Elijah, has Elijah not become void? Has it not become total darkness? So that person that there is need for liberation. So for God to have seen the need for you to see that tonight, that this crusade is coming, God loves Elijah. God loves all of you. And I pray for anyone watching me, connected to me right now, by the anointing that break yoke, I want to let you know every darkness that is sitting on Elijah, if your only can be the loudest, that darkness will crash for you. Darkness represent spiritual attacks, spiritual forces. In Psalm 74, verse 20, and he was getting us clear, have respect unto the covenant, for the dark places of this head are full of what? Habitation of cruelty. What does it mean? The dark places of this head are full of habitation of wickedness, exchange of life, exchange of destiny, people glory being exchanged, people destiny being exchanged. But what good news that I have for you, every darkness that is residing in your family, residing in Elijah, residing in your destiny, that has turned the people destiny upside down, if your amen can be the loudest where you are worshiping me, tonight I call the darkness to catch fire. I destroy that darkness in the name of Jesus. I send the darkness away in the name of Jesus. Can I hear that in my roar like thunder? Psalm 74, verse 20 say, have respect unto the covenant, for the dark places. In 1 John chapter 5, verse 19, the Bible said, the whole world lieth in wickedness. So the world itself is wickedness. But there are levels of difference of wickedness. In that Ephesians 6, if you analyze the level of wickedness, I'm talking about the rulerness of darkness and wickedness in high places, talking about principalities. So there are forces of level. That is why in certain places people are growing, other places they don't grow. Lives are changing for others, though some nothing is working. You want to hear a company coming, they will sit on it. A job is coming, they will sit on it. Many things are coming, they will sit on it. These are the wickedness in high places. The whole world lieth in wickedness. Shout out God. What does darkness represent? Darkness represents spiritual blindness. In 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 4, the Bible says, for the gods of this earth has blind their mind, that this they can't see that God is God. What does that mean when it says for the God of this world? It means the gods of this world are the things people run after. The image and idol that are deities, the sacrifice and the things they go and meet, the things they throw inside water, the things they bow down to. The Bible describes them the gods of this world. And you look at it very clear, God himself who created them just to test your integrity of fellowship, to test whether you bow down to them, you left the God who created those things, then you went to the things he created and he said, don't bow to these things. So what it mean by to them means the gods of this earth has taken hostage, has blinded their mind, and so that they would not see the efficacy of the glory of God that is existing. What has God sent me to do tonight is just to send every darkness that has blinded people, worshiping him, worshiping the image of darkness, the image of witchcraft, marine, whatever has kept them in captivity for many years, to set their life free and free forever. Tonight, I pray for somebody. I don't know where they are worshiping idol in your family till now, or they are worshiping shrine and what they bow to, or they dedicated you to the gods of those things. By the anointing of the Holy Ghost, if your enemy can run like thunder, God will come upon you tonight. You shall be separated from the gods. You shall be separated from the powers. Can I hear that amen, Lord? He said, whom the gods of this earth has blinded the eyes. It's unfortunate when you see people carry the gods, that the God who created them, they don't carry it in that form. And you know, in Elijah here, it's very alarming. The last time I came here, they were doing a feast, a bar rounding up, you know. In that they said, whom the God of this world had blinded the mind of them which believeth not, lest the light of the glory of the gospel. So when you see where they set up image, they set up idols, they set up deities, and they go and serve them, they worship, they bow down. What does it say, sir? They have given themselves to the gods of this world. When the Bible describes as the darkness himself. And if you watch clearly, people who does that, check the history of their family. There is always a hard retrogression, dangerous setback, manipulation maritally. Nothing seems to work. Stagnation that cannot be explained. You see their ladies wallowing deep in immorality. They deep down in prostitution without knowing why. The other day here, one young lady, I won't call her young, very big lady. She's married and the father was one of those popular men here, I won't mention deep. And the cause of, in my office, she was, God help her to come there to assist her with one or two business or so. She was just lucky, you know. And the demon was talking through what she was saying. That their father dedicated her to the water, to the river, to the goddess and this and that. And that is a demon that is tormenting her. Even in her marriage, the day she does not go out to sleep with men, it's like she has committed sin to the gods. Not knowing what she's doing against herself. These are the things we are talking about. But by the hand of God tonight, deliverance has come. That person that shouted that amen, I said deliverance has come. By the mercies of God tonight, I see the totality of freedom coming on your life, coming in Elijah. Can I hear that amen roar like thunder, like fire? Finally, darkness represents curses and covenants. Darkness represent curses, represent covenants. When you carry darkness in your life, it's like a cloth. The Bible described that in Psalm 109 verse 18. It said he has clothed himself with a cloth of curses. You see somebody raining curses to his daughter, to his son, you will not end well. You shall not see the next day. In fact, they said, I'm not your father. The Bible described they cover themselves with curses. So when they speak out, darkness go in action. And these are forces that enter people to speak to what will affect the genesis of the children's life. And it ended them in wasting and not to become anything. Many giants, born great. In those days, Elijah was one of the best place people lodge. One of the best place people want to be. A lot of persons have passed through this place. Me, by the grace of God, I used to come here once in a while in those days. But what is Elijah looking at? You hear this one said, I pack out. This one said, I pack out. The reason for the crisis is not for anything, sir. It's just darkness that is at work. When the darkness need blood, they come together. Before this crisis, check our prophecy of 2 years or 3 years ago. I told them of a crisis that was coming in a crossover night. I mentioned it particularly. I mentioned the one that was coming inside worry that many years ago. I mentioned it particularly. The Lord took me under the water and saw me their tank that was empty. And they said, we need blood. How are we going to get the blood? Let us, crisis and blood will be coming. I said it and nobody shake. Nobody bothered. Where today, it is not what we are seeing. Lives have been wasted. Men who would have stand for family have gone. What are they fighting for that they will come and they will not carry to anywhere? The demon just wants to see blood. He wants to see life and destiny. That is a spirit of boasting. Do you know me? Do you know we have this? Do you know we have that? What is behind is darkness. That is why God has sent me to bring light, to pronounce light on this community, pronounce light on everybody. And I pray that after today, anything that is representing darkness, thou shalt be loose. If your amen is the loudest, thou shalt be loose. I said, thou shalt be loose. If you shout that amen, you already loose. In the name of Jesus. I want to let you know tonight that God has the capacity who created the heaven and earth and pronounced from the day of creation to turn the darkness in your family to light. To turn the darkness in the community to light. To turn the darkness in your own life, in your business to light. He has the capacity to do that. The only thing you need to do is just the way you have set up this crusade. It's not enough to set up the crusade. You have to return to him and say, Jesus, we want you into this community. We want you to live with us. We have been doing it by our strength. We want you to remember us again. The glory we have lost, we want it to come back. And I know by the encounter of grace that you pronounce that tonight, deliverance has finally come. What are the keys for your access? Number one is receiving Jesus to the community, receiving every principles that can help you take a new leaf. We are going into another year now, 2020. Years back, Nigeria government was trying to create Vision 2020, far back Obasanjo time. But to date, as we speak, the vision was washed away. Nothing came out of it. And we are back as if we have never been a democracy. Now, where do we start from? Because we miss the light. Once you miss the light, the other thing is calculation. Once you miss the light, the other thing is struggle. Once you miss the light, to use your human initiative and imagination. If Nigeria has killed long ago to 2020, by now would that be different? Few months ago, by the grace of God, I was in Dubai. And they told me Dubai was like this desert, this open land field with some little thatched houses around. And they came together and said, let us make Dubai, Dubai. And they went and started looking for the best company, the best industry, the best structures, and let's duplicate it better so that people can come to Dubai. Today, as we speak, now everyone is going to Dubai for holiday. Everyone wants to be Dubai. If you go to Dubai now, that was 1979. Dubai now look like, in fact, in all over the world, they call it now the latest country, the latest city everybody want to be. Even in Brazil, they tell you that Dubai is now the latest city. Why? Light came there. Shadow of God, it is hard time. We take Jesus. We accept him as the light to turn the darkness away. We have used our human calculation. We have gods that we served. We give Ogogoro in the money. We give many things and bow down to them. What we need now is a light. And once you accept the light, the darkness does not need to struggle. Once light shines here now, darkness. If all this light are put off, you see darkness. So what do you need? Just on the switch. And the switch is the Holy Ghost. Once you put it on, the darkness knows he has no business. So get Jesus tonight. Get the Holy Ghost tonight. And I tell you, it will be different as you have been. There are a lot of persons here who gave their life to Christ in the church. They are regretting every day. I wish I knew him. I wish I gave my life to God. I wish I served him. That's what they are saying now. Well, some of you are sitting there. We have one of our mama here. Maybe tomorrow she will share testimony. I wish I knew him before this time. Well, many of you are still carrying those things that have no effect, that has no life. Would you drop him and let him help you? He said, come unto me, all you that labor with heavy laden, and then I will give you what? A rest. How many of you need a rest? It is not coming here to give your life to Christ. When you go back, you say, well, I came, I saw the face of the man of God. He's very handsome. That is not what God is looking. It's to give your life to Jesus. I am one of your sons. I am a son of this land. I'm a son of this soil. If I have not given my life to Christ, you won't know me. If I have not given my life to Christ, I won't stand here. So I'm here to tell you today, it pays to serve God. How many want to genuinely give their life to Jesus? If you are one of them here, I want to count 1 to 5. And I make sure you are not the last person to be at the front. Make sure you are the one of the 15 person to be at the front. And the God of all flesh will touch you tonight. I'm counting 1 to 5. Lord, I want to surrender my life. I want to give my life to Jesus. I want to be hear the testimony of this young man to be part of me. The first 15 persons, the fire of the light will come upon you. And you will never remain the same. And the mighty hand will come upon you. Wherever you are, I'm counting 1 to 5 now. Make sure you are not the last to be here. Run to the front and say to Jesus tonight, I surrender. I want your light in my life. Make sure you are not jogging, you are not strolling. I'm counting wherever you are watching me, hearing me. Make haste to be at the front. 1, 2. Don't sit down with the grace that God has come to give to you. Make sure you are not the last. Pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Now look at this. Stretch your hand here. Say, Holy Spirit, I want you into my life. I want to be saved. I've been living my own way.
come into my life. Baptize me with your holiness, with your righteousness. I want to share the same testimony of salvation like your servant. Help me, Lord, to be free indeed from the sin and lust and bondage of this world. Come into my life. Give me revelations to follow you, to love you, in Jesus' name. I pray for every one of you here. You will not just come out, but the Lord will use you. Your family will be proud of you. Elijah shall be proud of you. In Jesus' name I prayed. Let that amen be loudest. All right. Because of they have taken your name. Look at me. Look at me. All of you, please go to that side, so that the counselors can attend to you. Let them give me your form, your name, so that I can take them along and pray with them tonight. Just follow them there. Follow them there. What did I say you should come with tomorrow? Please follow them. Nobody should go away. I want to take your prayers and pray with you. Lift up your hands. Say, Holy Spirit, I have struggled enough. Let the light come upon me. Open your mouth and pray the prayer. I want your light. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Now hold the hand of somebody that can pray for you. What is your prayer for that person? Every darkness sitting upon your life, sitting upon your destiny, I shake the darkness from you. Are you ready to pray for that person? Are you sure? Hold that person very well. Hold the hand of that person very well now. Say, my brother. There's somebody here. There is something running your body. And that thing that is running is giving you arthritis. Since that thing started running, it gives you arthritis. It's not just something running, but it's giving you serious arthritis. The word I'm seeing is graduating from arthritis and stroke your bone, this spinal bone, and it will affect your life. If there's anybody God has come to help tonight, you are that person. I send that arrow far from you now. In Jesus' name I prayed. Check yourself. Check it. Run fast to the front. The thing disappeared now. As I mentioned the case, check that moving that gives you arthritis just left you right away. I'm waiting for that person. Check it. The bone, the body is free. You are light, as I mentioned the case. I'm waiting for that person. Check yourself. No trace of that moving object and that arthritis. The Lord just take it away from you. It's an idol that is fighting you. I'm waiting for you at the front. Fast. Move to the front. Don't waste the time. Fast, fast. Hold the hand of that person. What is your prayer? Say, you that darkness. Say louder with force that you want to see the light. You that darkness. Shout it with anger in your spirit. You that darkness. That is sitting upon my life. Upon the life of my sister and my brother. Shake it out. In Jesus' mighty name, shake it. Meet the second person. What are you going to pray? Say, my sister. When we say darkness, if there is any area in your life God have not answered, and you cannot help yourself in that area, you have tried, that's the darkness.
I use the word darkness represent unsettlement. There's somebody here, you have a strange cough. The cough has refused to go. You have done everything, the cough is still tie you there. The Lord have delivered you from that spirit of death. Run fast to the front now. There's another person here, you have this left part of your chest beating fast, and the thing has been affecting you seriously. Palpitation, you can't sleep well. I just saw the power of God heal you right now. Check yourself, meet me at the front here. Hold the hand of that person and pray this prayer. Say, my sister, every darkness occupying your glory, occupying your star, as I shake you now, I shake you out. Shake it, shake it out. Shake it out. Shake it out. Shake it out. Shake the darkness away. Shake it out. Every darkness occupying your glory, your destiny, your star, shake it out. In Jesus' name we pray. Hold another third person now. This one, you are going to shift the prayer, but be careful. I don't want you to spread the sand. Just follow me. What is your prayer? Say, my brother. Don't take, I'm not giving you prayer points. And I'm not, I hardly repeat prayers, but the Lord said, continue. Say, my sister. Every darkness you have been sold to, living inside you. You have been sold to me. You were dedicated, or somebody reported you to witchcraft, or your mother, your father, somebody did it to you, and they said that area cannot be solved, and all your family is struggling in that area. Are you ready to pray now? Say, my sister, every darkness you have been sold to, as I jump and shake you now, I shake the darkness away. Oh, shake it out, shake it out. Don't spare the darkness. Every darkness you have been sold to, shake it out. Out. Shake it out. Something has happened to them. That demon, that spirit, that power working against you. Something is happening. Oh, continue. Shake it out. Fire. 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 Every darkness you have been sold to, I send you away. Jesus' mighty name we pray. The first prayer now, you are praying this one for yourself. Leave that person. This one, something wants to happen now. What is this prayer? Any strong man living inside of me like a darkness, as I jump now, I shake you out. The Bible says, awake, awake, O daughters of Zion, Isaiah 52, and shake thyself from the dust. That is to say, there is dust. What is the dust? The dust is a serpent. The Lord said that the dust, serpent without it. What is the dust? The dust is the spirit of death. Who is dust? Man is dust. Awake, awake, shake that, shake it from the dust. When the Lord said to the serpent, dust without it, the serpent does not eat dust, he eat fowl, he swallow egg. Sometimes he will go and eat some ant, frog. It's talking about spiritual serpents. It says if you break an edge, the serpent will what? Bite. So where is the serpent biting from? Is it in the bush? Is it in the house? It's a spiritual serpent. So when he says, awake, awake, all daughters of Zion, shake thyself from the dust. Hey! A lot of people would think, what is God saying? Do not have dust in my body? He's telling you, one, number one, dust, the spirit of death. Number two, dust, the spirit of failure. Number three, does the spirit of stagnancy. Number four, the serpent of your father, your mother house. But people read the Bible and just quote, shake yourself from the dust. What is he talking about? Somebody, God is about to give you strong deliverance. Are you ready to shake yourself? The dust represent the idol of your father, your mother, as the spiritual husband, the spiritual wife. I want you to take this prayer serious. After this prayer, I may not pray more than two prayers. Take it serious. Say, you the spiritual dust that is inside me as a serpent, as a darkness, as a jubilee, I shake it out. Those spirits are shaking off, shake it from my head. Those spiritual dust acting as a serpent, as a stagnation, as a cessation, I shake it out. I shake it out. Come out, out, out. Somebody's getting blue right there.
is there. I separate you from the dust, from the stroma, from the stroma, from the stroma, from the stroma. In Jesus' mighty name, you are separated.
That is a good one. Two more prayers before we continue. And what is the prayer? This is not prayer. This is what the Lord is taking me to your family. Number one, every pot buried in my father's house that have swallowed the glory of the family, I stand to break that pot now. Can you break the pot? Close your eyes and break it now. Say, you know pot buried in my family house, buried in my family compound. I am so stand here now. Name we have prayed. Then we want to go deeper to something now. Whatever has been buried in my father's house, in my mother's house, whether they are dead or alive and is affecting us, I uproot you now. You know, I did not know where they buried my grandmother here, but when I saw what I saw in the dream, I said, I've not dreamed this kind of dream in my life once. What is happening? I called my uncle. Show me where they bury your mama. I ask them, your mama serves so I do? Say yes. So something happened? Say yes. So something happened? Say yes. Show me where they bury her. Don't die. You know, because they die, they challenge us with their life. I went there. I shot the darkness here. I shot here. I shot here. Never again. You may not, you will not know what I came here to do for you. Something is happening already. I want you to pray this prayer. Say anything buried in my family compound. That is a fitting is not to settle away. Financially, you are not there. Marriage, you are not there. To some, they have one. Others, they don't have one. This one, they have one. Others, they are lucky. Who said? Is God a wicked God? The foundation is a problem. Say as I stand here now, I appear there in the spirit. I put something out. The Bible said the weapons of your warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty in power. In pulling down. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. I was trying to round up and pray for the light. The Lord said no. There are three ladies that they use chain to tie. If they want to get pregnant, the pregnancy does not stay. Said another one there, nothing work. This is how many business now? Look at the serpent they ran. He said, look at another one. The big chain, padlock the family. He said, what do I do? He said, pray. Let them break the chain. I don't know who is ready to be free now, but this prayer will bring total deliverance to many of you tonight. There's somebody here, a lady here, you are attacked with the spirit of asthma. This asthma wasn't there. It came from the dream. You have been dying and managing this thing. As Weba mentioned in the case, the power of darkness took the asthma they gave you. They said, go, we don't want you again. And now I see the asthma return back to the sender. Check yourself very fast and run to the front. That inhaler, the Lord has taken it back. They have carried their load. Somebody, you are going to pray this prayer. Every chain used to tie me down, despite my serving, my faithfulness to God, that the chain said I will never be settled in this area. Look at it. As I jump now, aggressive, I break the chain. Are you ready now? So people have been asking you, are you sure you are serving God? And God have not answered in this area. There are some things money can do. There are some things money cannot do. Ezekiah cried to God. He said, this one is not medical condition. This one, God, you need to answer me. I want you to cry that prayer, that kind of cry, that kind of prayer. Say the every witchcraft chain used to padlock my destiny, but I cannot settle the
They are broken. Lift your right hand to the altar. You're going to pray this prayer. Once I pray for you, you shout one, fire, two, fire, three, fire, four, fire, five, six, seven. You will smite the head. That is your star. And you will twist once very hard and shout, fire! Are you ready now? Now stretch your hand. When I start counting, one, you shout fire, two, fire, three, fire, four, fire. Father, I release a fire for divine magnets. Any spirit that is inside you, any covenant and altar that is inside you, any power that is inside you, any witchcraft being practiced with your destiny, any identity or power of the enemy walking around your glory, because of this privilege encounter tonight, I send the fire to you right now. I declare the fire to locate the altars, locate the shrine, locate the evil dedication, locate the witchcraft power, locate the stagnation, locate the spirit of death. The strong one that fire, you can never be free. Let the fire locate them now. One shall fire. Remember the last one you shall fire. You now hit your head. Fire. Two shall fire. Two shall fire.
Persons there. Every mirror they say you will serve and you refuse. And the mirror has been tormenting you. The anointing is coming on the first person there. Let the fire break the mirror. Deliver that person now. Out! Number two. Anyone here that your dowry has been paid in the water and they say you can never enjoy marriage. Lift your hands. I pray for this person now. Let the fire bring that person out. That's good. As I count one to two, receive the fire. Fire! 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 Out! Number three, lift up your hands. Every mark of rejection and hatred, mark of stagnation, nothing you do, they celebrate you.
always quarry, anger, fighting. Every evil mark upon you, let the mark catch fire now. That's good, that's good, that's good. Number four person there, I pray for you. That witchcraft locker they used to lock your destiny, they lock you up that nobody can see your star. With the fire, look at it. I command the anointing to locate that person. Break that locker, break that locker, break that locker. Break, 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 break. That witchcraft eye, your family, I blind the eye. I command the eye to be blind. The amen is simple. I command the eye to be blind. Every spirit that monitors you to this program, I want to reinforce on you. I command the spirit to catch fire. Every door of witchcraft attack open against your family, I command the door to catch fire. Every spirit that is angry that you want to serve God, you keep falling and rising, I command that spirit to catch fire. Every mark of frustration and say you will waste your time serving God, that person the Lord is showing me, I declare, receive deliverance, receive deliverance, receive deliverance, receive deliverance, receive, 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 receive. Lift up your hands. I pray for this person now. That power coming to attack you in the dream, feed you in the dream, messing you up in the dream, making love to you. As I count 1 to 5, let the covenant between you and that power break. 1, 2, 3, 4. Fine. I declare the light on this person. Lift your hand and pray the last prayer. Say, my light shine. The light of Elijah shine. Can you say louder? Say, you are the light of my glory. You are the light of Elijah. Jesus' mighty name we pray. Finally, stretch your hand to the altar. Stretch your hand. Like somebody receiving from God. I pray. Anyone here, the Lord is showing me that they have already emptied your life. Tonight, I pray. Let that emptiness that they have used to do something in their cove backfire and return your star back. Yeah. That person that cannot turn your neck very well, check it. The Lord just see you right now. Run fast to the front. I pray for somebody again. Every darkness that follow you from place to place, no matter what you do, they go there and spoil you. They go there and cause problem for you. But God offended. Answer you tonight. Answer you tonight. Lord, I don't know, be louder. Any area of your life that is yet unsettled by the anointing that brought this program, I command that head of the serpent cut off. Receive your settlements. Receive your settlements. Can I hear that amen roar like thunder? Finally, I pray for somebody here. That stroke you are carrying, the Lord has just delivered you. Check your body and run fast to the front. The Lord has healed you from that stroke. I pray for somebody that cannot see with your two eyes clearly. The Lord has just opened your eyes. Another person cannot see with one part of your eye, check it, the Lord has healed you. Somebody again, right side of your ear, the Lord has healed you. There's a sister here, your name is Maureen. The Lord is telling me, everyone in your family has been tied down and nothing is working for anybody, including you. Nothing to show. Marriage, break, break, break. Everybody's living a rejected life. I don't know whether you are hearing me now, and the Lord wants to deliver another of your sister and deliver another person because of you are here. Right there. Run fast to the front. I break that covenant upon that family. And I use that family, that Maureen, to deliver that family here. Every covenant of a settlement, the curse is broken. There's somebody here, the spirit of death is not far from you 2 days from now. I see cut to your mouth, your nose. But because of this program, I send that arrow back to sender. I pray for another person here. They cover you with something different. By the power of the Holy Ghost, I command that they used to cover you to catch fire. I pray for somebody here. That stubborn pursuer pursue you. The Lord said, I should tell you, they will not cross to see the next year. Every prison that locks somebody here, I bring the prison up. The woman is super, I bring the prison up. In the name of Jesus. That person, when you put your leg on the ground shock you. The arrow have disappeared. Shake yourself and the case and the name, make sure. Shake your case, run fast to the front. Finally, I pray for you. By tomorrow, we will be blessing the oil and the salt and the oil, the water. Anything left the Lord have not done, the Lord will do them. All the gates, they lock in Alaja spiritually. I declare the gates lifted. The gates of Alaja, they lock to the eye of the federal government not to see the DSC. Not to see Alaja as a place. The power that want to turn Alaja to desert, I command the power to catch fire. Every key I'm missing where they gang up to put Alaja in darkness, that darkness is over. From today, light comes to Alaja. I'm not hearing amen. From today, light shine in Alaja. From tonight, let there be light. And anybody that is angry with this crusade, I send the angel of death against them. Let the God of freedom visit them tonight. Let the angel of fire visit them tonight. That serpent that I'm seeing that is angry, twisting himself, I cut you off. I cut off your neck, I cut off your head. I send you back in the name of Jesus. From today, Alaja will know peace. The community that have crisis with Alaja, they will know peace. No more quarrel from today. Every demon that wants to regroup, reinforce, let God disgrace them. I bring the message and the prayer of God, the light of God to shine in Alaja. The Bible said the light shine it, and the darkness compared it not. Tonight I pray for somebody here. The Lord will visit you mightily in the dream. The old man is super. The Lord will visit you mightily in the dream. That person that is saturated with spirit of borrowing, I destroy that yoke. I destroy that spell. In the name of Jesus. That fibroid in your womb, I command it to disappear. That womb pain, I command it to disappear. That infection you have been treating for 3 years, I command it to disappear. From tonight, receive an angelic visitation. I declare total restoration. The Bible says, the Son of Man sets you free. Indeed, somebody shall save you. I am free indeed. Congratulations. The cases I mentioned of the name and those cases, if you are one of them, run fast to the front so that I can use fire to seal up your case for you. Many of you have been watching me on the television projector, but I am not in projector now. I am in physical here with you. Praise the Lord. Father, let your fire pass through them. Attend to those one that cases were mentioned so that I can seal it up with enough fire tonight. Let anything that is not planted by you working against them, let it be exposed. I only pray for two persons in that deliverance case, that the powers of darkness have tied down. Whatever tie you down, head you down, that say your life cannot go forward, let the fire locate now. Two of you there. Let the fire touch you, manifest from whatever is heading you back. Enter just two persons there, that the demons of darkness have head down. Let the spirit that head you down manifest. So I count one, two, three, fire! Two important cases. Fire! Find the leg. Fire the head. Every spirit hiding inside you. Oh yeah. Expose yourself. Manifest out. Fire!
Jesus! Jesus! Jesus!
That person God want me to attend to is still hiding in their midst. Holy Ghost, bring that person out. Bring that person out. Fire! Who are you? Who are you? Stop us my time. Who are you?
What is your mission against our lives?
To destroy her.
To destroy her?
Yes.
What have you destroyed in her life?
She can never get married.
Who are you that wants to destroy her that can never get married? Huh? She can never get married. So what other thing have you destroyed in her life?
Anger.
Gave her a spirit of anger?
Yes.
What again did you give to her? Huh?
I want
out to give birth from gate to gate.
So how many have you made out to give birth to? Huh? How many has she given birth to from one gate?
Two.
She has given birth to two gates.
One gate.
She has given birth to two in one gate.
Yes.
So why did you want her to move from man to waste her life? Huh?
Because
yes,
she has a very bright future. So, I want to destroy her.
So who are you that wants to destroy her?
You want to know?
Yeah.
I will never tell you.
Fire your mouth.
Okay.
Who are you? Huh? Who are you that want to waste and destroy?
Leave me alone.
That want to move from man to man. Huh?
From my mother's side.
Who gave her to you? How many are you inside her?
Accountable
demons. From the mother's side.
Yes.
So what kind of life did you compare them to live from that side? Huh? What kind of life do they live?
I will not tell you.
Speak out! Receive fire mouth! Fire mouth! It's wasting my time. What kind of life do you compare them to live?
Any kind of life.
What kind? Name them.
They are very many. I cannot name them.
Tell me.
Let me go.
Tell me only two of them. Two kind of life you compare them to live.
Beg. I better leave you.
Fire your leg. Fire your mouth. What kind of life did you compare them to live? You say you don't want her to stay in a marriage. You want
don't want her
to stay in a marriage.
Yes.
What you take the joy.
Yes.
You take the pleasure.
Oh.
That it should move from man to man.
Man to man. Yes.
That's
what I want.
That's what you want.
Yes.
So you have done it to others in the family. So have you started it with her to be moving around?
You want me how? Even a younger one. Yes.
The same thing. They're already moving from man to man.
Yes.
So why did you want to waste and destroy their marriage, their life, their glory?
Because they have a very bright future.
So you are the power from the
mother's side.
You don't want people to stay in a marriage.
Yes, so.
Yes, so every power that does not want you to be settled, I pray for you tonight, that demon is arrested. Yeah. I told you, I said darkness is the reason for what? A settlement. All right, let the fire separate you from that spirit. Never again you use her. Let her be used by the Holy Ghost.
Out!
Break your covenant. Take your property from her. In Jesus' name you are free. Look for the person God wants me to help in their midst. A serious case. Holy Spirit, whether the young children or not, a very serious one. Who are you inside her? Who are you?
My father's wife, he get to you there, kill you too.
I tell you.
He has no to kill me inside. I said no.
He asked you to kill others.
Yes.
That is spirit of witchcraft. I'm coming.
He has two wife is there.
Listen to me.
Kill me inside.
Who are you? Come. My dear, how are you?
I'm fine, sir.
Where do you live?
Alaja, yeah.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
We are in Alaja.
Close to Waterside.
Where's your husband?
No husband.
Who can give you two children? How many children do you have?
Two boys.
Where the man will give you the boys?
We separated.
Where is your sister?
She's not here. Where is Lisa?
She's married.
No, sir.
She's having the same problem.
Yes, sir.
What kind of problem?
changing from man to man.
I pray for you tonight.
I receive.
God will give you the man that will stay with you.
Amen.
Did you want it?
Yes, sir.
You don't like moving from man to man?
No, I don't like it.
You don't like it?
Yes, I want to be with man.
And you could not help yourself? The curse is broken.
Amen.
The yoke is broken.
Amen.
From today, receive the spirit of settlement.
Amen.
I cause that darkness on you and your sister to disappear. In Jesus' name. Where is your mother?
Mother is late.
She's well with you.
Amen.
Okay, don't worry. Next person. Receive fire now. Fire. Fire. Who you be inside? You say now your papa wife?
Yes, he keep picking.
Now he can say make you do a thing.
He say he won't give me sight.
He say he won't do a thing?
Give me sight.
Kill you inside?
Yeah.
Why he say he won't kill you? He say make you kill somebody?
Yeah, he say some juju.
He can say make you kill somebody too?
Yeah.
He give you the power too?
Yes.
He will say make you can't kill?
I kill children.
You can't give the children?
No, I leave the children, I kill one.
You kill one of your children?
Yes.
Your papa wife kill one?
Yes.
You kill one?
Yes.
And you they stay with her?
Yes.
How many children you get?
Six children.
How many call remain?
Three children.
Three don't die?
Yes.
Who kill the three?
Not my papa.
Who be your papa, your papa wife?
Yes.
Your papa wife?
Yes.
Now your papa wife?
Yes.
You kill one inside?
Yes.
Why you kill one?
Because they stubborn, not they go school.
Now make you kill them?
Yes, they serve juju.
Who they serve juju so?
Now my papa.
Your papa too they serve juju?
Yes.
Where for they serve the juju?
You know they go church.
You know where for they serve the juju?
Inside shrine.
Where the shrine there?
Inside glam.
Now the body had that so. Okay, let the spirit of witchcraft and idol come off for your body now. Oh yeah, go! Fire! Ah! Stop it! Ah! The spirit using you to fight, break the covenant, total separation. All over your head, your body! Fire! Ah! Ah! More fire! More fire! Ah! 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 In Jesus' name you are free. That's the end. We go hit another person like that. So when I reach 15, all the demon go pack and all of you will be free. Young girl, I don't know how to speak the robot for her now. How are you?
Fine. Fine.
Tivo wonure.
Bagolo.
Me vowena. If you bo be weje, Igbagola warure.
Yes.
Who they serve juju?
My papa.
What of your papa wife?
They serve two, not the go church.
How many children your papa wife get?
Six.
How many don't die?
Three don't die.
Yeah.
Won't kill me, so I say no. I got a pastor Joma picking.
Hey. Praise the Lord. God of free indeed, they enter everywhere. Praise the Lord. Alright, let me do the counting. Now, it is your turn. All of you that are there, open your hearts and let God touch you. Holy Spirit, tonight is a night. Ministers, help them. None of them will go back the same. The fire and the grace will help you. You'll be free from that covenant, that altar, that demon forever. In the name of Jesus. Receive fire. One. Every foundation that has put darkness in your foundation. Fire! Manifest. Take the property and go. That's good. Two, three, fire! Take it out. Separate. Whatever you have done to tie it down. Fire! That's good. Fire! Five! Every strong man inside you. Take your property from them and go. Six! Fire your head! Fire your leg! Seven! Fire! Two are standing there. The Lord wants to touch. Let the fire bring you out. Bring you out! Fire! Fire! Eight! That's good. That's good. Remaining one of them there. Standing there. The Lord wants to help you. Eight. Fire. Every darkness.
Stronger, idol, foundation, hiding inside you. Take them out, take them out, take them out. Fire, holiness, fire, nine, bam, remaining five. 11, fire, stronger, reason, stronger, spiritual man, spiritual man, idol, foundation, dedication, 12, fire, 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 holiness, fire, like, fire, 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 every stronger, 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 stronger. Hiding inside you, that's come out, come out, come out. Take them out, take them out. Don't look at that, take them out, let them take them out. 12. Floor. Jesus name you are free. Total freedom. Jesus name you are free indeed. In Jesus name. Congratulations.
Our sister here, she said for the past 2 weeks it's been terrible. She cannot bend. As a matter of fact, the situation made her look like an old and elderly person. But after the word from your mouth, she's okay now. Let's hear from her briefly.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
My name is Georgina Osieta. For the past 2 weeks, I had a dream and three guys were chasing me. And I fought with them very well. Since that time, I've been having these pains in this part of my body. It's as if it's stroke. Sometimes when I'm walking, it's as if I cannot raise this my left leg. And my spinal cord, I can't bend properly. But that's man of God, and servant of God, make sure my case. I believe I am free and I can bend my waist properly now. Praise the Lord!
Let's jam those hands together for Jesus for that instant miracle. You are not clapping. Jam those hands together for Jesus. Another amazing miracle here, that information of someone who have poor vision. Our sister said for the past 2 years, her vision has been blurry. She's not able to see very well. As a matter of fact, she couldn't even look at the light. But after the word came out of the man of God, her vision is clear now. She can see very well, and she's here to testify.
I don't talk.
Ma, tell us your name.
My name is Tina.
Okay. How did you do it before?
They pay me.
Okay.
So as a man of God,
you defeat the sea well before.
And they see, but they pay me.
They pay you.
Yes.
So the light also they affect you.
Since I won't even go out, but as my job bearer.
Oh, so see what you call since you won't even go out because of the light.
The high they pay me. So as a man of God, make sure the case, the high pain just go.
And now you can look at the light. Let's jump those hands together for Jesus. Instant miracle. You are not clapping those hands for Jesus. Also, that information of someone who has been having a case of a very funny case of stagnation. Things are not working. And now she's here to testify briefly of her.
Praise the Lord. My name is Ablessing Jobome. By His grace, I came to this program with an expectation. I came to this program with an expectation that I refuse to be stagnant. And today, the man of God, when he was ministry, he makes sure stagnation, that you are free from stagnation. And I believe it, and I felt the power of God came upon me so mighty, and I was free. I want to give praise to Jesus. Hallelujah.
Let's jump those hands together for Jesus. Also, that you mentioned of someone who had a case of terrible palpitation. And that you also mentioned this person is unable to sleep. As I said, for the past 1 week, the chest pain has been terrible because of the palpitation. But after the word, she's free now. Briefly, let's hear from her.
I don't go free now. For like 1 week now, I don't feel the sleep, I don't feel the rest. But as far as pastor don't pray for me, I'm free. I am free indeed. Praise the Lord.
Let's jump those hands together for Jesus. Also, that the mention of someone who has a case of a terrible cough. He said for a very long time the cough has been disturbing her. As a matter of fact, the cough is because of spirit of death. Her mommy used to confirm her prophecy, and that's been her case for the past 7 months. He's gone to the hospital, they couldn't detect anything, and she'll be having terrible dreams. And that's the spirit of death. Briefly, let's hear from her.
Okay. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So that is 7 months when I've been saying, I just cough, all my eyes, let's go to drink water. But when they go to hospital, where my children carry me go to hospital, they go reach there, they say no cough, nothing. So I can't start to go church for like that. Yeah. Now the prayer where they pray for me, I can't go to hospital back again. They can't say no still cough. God can't so can say the cough can't just go like that. The mess when they take, not be the mess in the book. I no say now God not hear me.
But the cough can't come back God. Again.
Then they before yesterday, I can't they sleep. Nine, this cough come back again. I can't say I want to stick up this cough again. with this kind body when I get like this, I say, God, I'm not fit.
So you watch people, they don't need to test anything for the cough?
Nothing for the cough.
They do all the tests, do stuff.
All the tests, not even nothing.
That arrow of death, so, God don't take away. Let's jam those things together for Jesus. You should do better for the God of freedom. Let's jam those things together for Jesus. For the sake of time, that is a mosh. We can take the rest of that. We share the testimonies tomorrow. Let's jam those things together for Jesus.
Give Jesus a big, 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 big hand.